Woohoo! Here we go! My recording's barely set up. I'm barely warmed up. But we are on the Z-Racing Coastal Crown Loop. Fans on high. Window size is kind of wrong, but man, that's what happens when you rush. And yeah, this is gonna be a hard one. Lots of climbing, not my strong point. But we'll see. We'll see what people wanna do. Feathers everywhere you turn in this one. Not sure how soon we get our first banner, but I think we get one before. I think we get two before the climb. And one in the middle of the climb. Oh, I have a friend in here. I wonder who it is. Decent sized field for this time of day. 23, I guess? Can't even read it. 15, 18. 23. I'm just gonna try and get whatever draft I can on the climb. Seems pretty draftable. I haven't raced it. I did it sort of fast in the Zwift Academy welcome ride. Just a couple people putting a little extra effort in the front. The welcome ride is maybe the worst time to pretend it's a race, but who cares? The rubber banding did not seem to be turned on, so had some fun with it, got a little extra workout. I don't think I need to do anything crazy here. I have a lot to learn about the descent as well. But yeah, so the way this goes, we go out this kind of flat bit, ever so slightly bumpy, couple banners, I think, and then a right turn up the, what is it, Maya? I think there's like, the climb is split in two with a little loop in the middle. Flat loop with the banner, so this is all the lead-in, including that climb up to the flat loop. Because that's the start-finish of the course. So then there's a climb out of that, which I think is a little bit harder. There's a couple pretty steep bits. And then you bomb down the grade and come around and do this part again in the lap proper. And then up the It's a Climb or the Mayan Climb. And to the finish. So I sort of would expect a couple light climbers to have their way. And maybe I'm left picking up the scraps. But we'll see. No idea who's in here. No idea. other than not having a warm-up, this pace is perfectly reasonable. You can tell by my power bar there. Bottom, at least the part that isn't hidden. And my camera, I see the whole thing. Got a feather. Really know the two climbs well enough to really know where to use the feathers, but generally speaking, hold on to them as long as you can is pretty good policy. And then we're going to go to the sprint banner here, so could just burn this one on the little bump before that stretch. We'll see if other people choose to put a cheeky dig in there. Seems like a safe choice here. Safe choice almost everywhere. See, there's a dig. I kind of like this move. Why not? Stage one difficulty. Not really worth it. I learned a bit there about how much more climbing there is. Man. Good point too. Good idea of where to deploy the feather. Finish if I'm in a position where that matters. A good little group here. Chase group only a few seconds back. Be on the front at all for this stretch. Flatter parts help a lot in this section. This is all about. on her right now. See how fierce it gets. My legs feel pretty good. I've wasted some effort though. So we'll see. Well, I'll have to, I don't know, wait, like, in some small way, my efforts contributed to the selection, so I can maybe not say that it was entirely wasted, but good attack here. Definitely not optimal. Let's go that way. Thank you. group here. 11, geez. Work, guys. Gals, any gals? Catch. No signs of any counter. Getting so close to the climb. Not often a B tactic. Compared to A, maybe. I feel like I see that more in A, but who knows? Probably just making stuff up. Alright. 2K. Ouch. Good job, guys. Awesome job. Yeah, a little cocky there. That was a great outcome for me, honestly. Could have held it just a touch longer. Those guys were on me. Give them credit. I thought I had a bigger gap. They didn't. They were motivated to chase me down. Very well done. I feel good about my effort. Also suffered a touch on the steering front. That is just a fact. I don't trust my steering, so I don't use it. Don't turn them on. And definitely helps me in that. Those 90 degree turns a lot. So credit there. Good use of the steering. But, you know, podium and a tough course. Legs felt good. Just didn't have the very last bit. Didn't quite have the timing. Yeah, I probably let that one get away. Didn't quite have the situation. I was focused so much on the timing for the feather. Didn't really think about firing it and then holding it for another 10 seconds or seeing what other people did. In retrospect, the thing to do on the uphill finish. My eyesight is hurting a little too. I'm gonna get an eye doctor. I'm having trouble reading. I couldn't quite see distance remaining. That's not a good thing. Get on that program, but I wasn't, that's really not the factor there. I knew the terrain of the finish well enough, just hadn't picked a sprint point or a go point. And it did feel good, like as I was looking to see what was happening. I did get a little gap, 7-8 meters, but not enough. It would have been enough if they were just toast, but they were not. They had everything they needed. So again, I have to give him credit. It was a good race. Legs felt great though, so that's a good thing. Took yesterday off. Did the Zwifty Drift for Alp handicap on Saturday and a fun outdoor ride on Sunday. Nothing too strenuous, but if you find that the outdoor riding, I mean, it's just a lot longer times on the bike, even if there's a lot of easier riding, it can still tire me out. So yesterday was a good off day, and legs felt good today as a result, so that's pretty awesome. See when we go to the results on Zwift power. What I was up against in that last group. I kind of thought there'd be more. It goes by pretty quickly at that pace. And there was a decent effort off the front, a couple efforts, and nothing crazy. Really just grinding people down, as climbs often do. So, I'll take this as a small victory, not a big victory. Podium. Good effort. First time racing on this course. Room for improvement. Great food for learning. Which is, I don't know what you look for in a race. Oops. All right. Getting close to the next level. Let's get it up there. Yeah, it was so wild. Like, you know that you can get gaps on the descent, but literally nobody coming with. And then, of course, you start dreaming of a real long gap and a breakaway, but it just wasn't there. It was like 4 seconds, and then the other guy came, and I just sat on his wheel. We were not going to get anywhere. I didn't want to let him go either, though. And I don't know if it was that same rider who went off the front for a while, and then this was the surge with the feather up the sprint ramp before the last banner, and then easy, and then, you know, I mean, it's sort of comparable. Second time up, first time up, and then, you know, this is where it got steeper, and then easy, and then boom. So, yeah. Good, strong effort there. 30. Not bad. All right, we'll see how badly I butchered this, the framing. It looks like I did okay. We'll see. I might get cropped a little, but c'est la vie. All right, well, that's another one in the books. Thanks for watching. Until next time. Ride on!